You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Riya Mohanty and today's headlines are... In India, the GDP growth has slowed down to 7.1% in September quarter. And thousands of farmers have marched through the streets of New Delhi to press their demands. In Punjab, State Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu has said that Congress President Rahul Gandhi sent him to Pakistan. And around 16 assistant sub-inspectors have injured in an accident. In Canada, the government has signed the USMCA with the US and Mexico. And hate crimes in Canada increased 47% in 2017. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab. For detailed news and business updates of the Indo-Canadian community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: the economic growth has slowed down to 7.1% in the July-September period against 8.2% in the June quarter. In the corresponding quarter last year, the GDP has grown 6.3%. At this rate, the GDP growth was the lowest in the three quarters, but still remained ahead of China. Thousands of farmers marched through the streets of New Delhi, chanting slogans and flashing flags to press their demands like debt relief and remunerative prices for their produce. They were joined by social activists and leaders of non-BJP parties in a show of strength near the parliament. Army Chief General Bipin Rawat feels that Pakistan's claim of taking strong steps towards a good bilateral relations is contradictory unless there is a direct impact visible on the ground about its claims. He added that a positive step from Pakistan is what is needed because India has a clear policy that terror and talks cannot go together. India could soon see the use of drones for transporting organs and other emergency medical supplies between hospitals under the new policy for remotely piloted aircraft. The government is examining the possibility of creating drone ports in hospitals to permit this kind of transportation. The Enforcement Directorate has summoned Robert Vadra, brother-in-law of Congress President Rahul Gandhi. This is in connection with its money laundering probe in a land scam case in Rajasthan's border city of Bikaner. The Congress has appointed former Indian cricket captain Mohammad Azharuddin as the working president of the party's Telangana unit. The move is being perceived as placating the former parliamentarian who is said to have been unhappy by the way the party was treating him. A Delhi court has held court ex-secretary A.C. Gupta guilty of corruption and criminal conspiracy. The case pertains to a coal scam case relating to allotment of coal blocks in West Bengal. The Delhi High Court has extended till December 15 its stay on the government decision to ban private firms from producing and selling oxytocin. The drug is used for inducing labor contractions and controlling bleeding. Two-time World Cup winning Australian forward Glenn Turner will work with the strikers of the Indian women's hockey team in a special 8-day camp. The Canberra hockey star, who was a part of the World Cup winning Australian squad in 2010 and 2014, arrived on Friday for the national camp. The Delhi High Court has sent Bollywood actor-comedian Rajpal Yadav to jail for 3 months. This is for failing to repay a loan of Rs. 5 crore taken by his company to make a movie. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
I was living my dream and had a happy life. One day, everything changed. I was overwhelmed with chronic pain and depression, and I was struggling to get my disability benefits. All I wanted was the assurance of my insurance company that I would get paid. But they didn't.
We decided to approach a trusted law firm in the community. Thanks to Kotek Law. Not only did I get my long-term disability settlement in no time, I got my confidence back to carry on with life, too.
We are your trusted disability lawyers at Kotek Law. We will fight to ensure that you get the benefits you deserve.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu has said that Congress President Rahul Gandhi is his captain and he has sent him to Pakistan for the Kartarpur Corridor Foundation laying ceremony. Sidhu made the statement in Hyderabad while campaigning for the Telangana Assembly election. Around 16 assistant sub-inspectors were among the 19 Punjab police employees who sustained injuries when a police bus rammed into a tractor-trailer on Sri Hargobindpur Road. All ASIs are investigating officers dealing with different cases in the Punjab and Haryana High Court. The Communist Party of India has played the state over the issue of withdrawal of facilities from scheduled caste and backward class students in the state. CPI Secretary Pant Brar claimed that the examination fee of SC students of class 10 and 12 has been doubled. SGPC President Gobind Singh Longowal has said that he did not recognize Pakistan-based pro-Khalistan activist Gopal Singh Chawla. The statement came after Longowal returned to India from Pakistan after sharing a frame with Chawla. The Gurugram police has busted 9 fake call centers and nabbed 12 persons for allegedly calling consumers across the globe on the pretext of providing them technical support. The accused were luring customers by using the name of cyber giant Microsoft. SAD President Sukhbir Singh Badal has urged the state to immediately pay dues worth Rs 400 crores to sugarcane growers. The SAD has also threatened to launch a huge protest if demands of farmers are not fulfilled by the government. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has granted regular bail to former DSP Daljeet Singh Dhillon in a raid case. Dhillon, who was an international hockey player, is currently confined in Ropar District Jail. Subsidized kitchen Sadi Rasoi is proving to be a white elephant for the district Red Cross Society in Muktsar. The kitchen offers a meal for just Rs 10. Its monthly expenses are nearly Rs 1.5 lakh, but the collection is just about 50,000 rupees. Punjab is on the verge of a huge win against Delhi in their Ranji Trophy encounter. Having bowled out Delhi for a par 307 in their first innings, Punjab responded with 282 runs, a lead of 175 runs. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows.
Realize your ambition of becoming a doctor at All Saints University School of Medicine. With small class sizes, affordable tuition and worldwide clinical clerkships, All Saints University brings a world of opportunity right to your feet. University and high school graduates are eligible for admission. To learn more, call us at 416-743-9222 or visit us at www.allsaintsuniversity.org.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: after much anticipation, Canada signed the revamped NAFTA in the Buenos Aires on the sidelines of the high-profile G20 summit. PM Justin Trudeau joined US President Donald Trump and the outgoing Mexican president to formally sign the USMCA. Hate crimes in Canada increased 47% in 2017, primarily targeting Muslim, Jews and black people. Statistics Canada said that the biggest increase was in crimes targeting Muslims in a year that saw a deadly mass shooting in a Quebec mall. Two separate investigations are underway into an altercation between two Niagara Regional Police officers that sent one to hospital in a critical condition. The Provincial Police and Ontario's Police Watchdog are investigating the incident. Former PM Stephen Harper could be dragged into the criminal case against Vice Admiral Mark Norman, as the suspended officer's lawyers seek access to secret government documents. Many of the records, including many deemed cabinet secrets or confidences, were created in Harper Regime. The findings of a special security review into PM Justin Trudeau's much maligned trip to India early this year will be released on Monday. A source said that the PMO doesn't see the report as a major concern, but the report's findings are acknowledged as not that good. Despite informing the PMO last week that he was resigning as an MP to deal with a gambling addiction, MP Raj Grewal remains a member of both the caucus and the House of Commons. The opposition has demanded for a clarification on when the PMO was informed about Grewal. The pace of economic growth in Canada slowed in the third quarter as business investment spending moved lower and the growth in household spending slowed. The economy grew at an annualized pace of 2.0% in the third quarter compared with 2.9% in the second quarter. Premier Rachel Notley said that Alberta needs to buy as many as 7,000 rail cars if it wants to meet the goal of shipping an additional 120,000 barrels of oil a day. Notley said that her province is prepared to buy roughly 80 locomotives, with each train pulling 100 to 120 cars. Eastern Ontario MPP Amanda Simard is leaving the Progressive Conservative Caucus and will sit as an independent. Amanda has been vocally opposed to her party's francophone policies over the last week and openly mused about her future with the PCs. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Debuting in the Hindi film industry under the Yash Raj Films banner opposite, Bollywood superstar Shah Rukh Khan is a dream for any aspiring actress. Anushka Sharma earned that opportunity and achieved more milestones in her decade-long career. As the actress gears up for the release of her upcoming film Zero, once again with SRK, says, her and Shah Rukh's character have challenges, but they have dreams and desires too. Anushka, who plays a NASA scientist and cerebral palsy in the film, told INS. Very interestingly, Anand sir and our writer celebrated the character beyond her physical challenges, and that is beautiful. It was a very well-researched script, and the projection of the character is a very positive, you know. She's very accomplished. As a professional, she's intelligent. My and Shah Rukh's characters have challenges, but they also have dreams and desires. On the other hand, Katrina's character has her challenges that are not so visible to people. Directed by Anand L. Rai, the story of Zero revolves around three characters played by Shah Rukh, Anushka and Katrina Kaif in the film. Zero is releasing on December 21st.
Actor Arjun Kapoor has started shooting for Ashutosh Govarikar's upcoming Panipat period drama. Arjun on Friday tweeted, "Embarking on a journey like never before with Ashutosh sir and our entire team." Actress Kriti Sanon, who is starring with Arjun in the movie, said she is excited to start this new chapter. She tweeted, "Our Panipat journey begins today. Super excited for this new chapter. Going to join you guys in 2 days. Let's do this. Panipat shoot begins today." Hindi literature poet and essayist Ashok Chakradhar has penned the dialogues for Panipat, which will tell the story of what led to the third battle of Panipat. It will be produced by Sunita Govarikar under their home banner AGPPL in association with Vision World. The film is slated to release on 6 December 2019. It also stars Sanjay Dutt. Actor-comedian Veer Das feels, warns and hopes that US President Donald Trump might just go away, but stops short of predicting his end of tenure as he compares him to the Star Wars movie series that keeps coming back. The comedian, who has never shied away from slamming Trump, tweeted this as, "I am not going to say this feels like the beginning of the end for Trump. I want to say it. It feels that way. I hope it is. But hey, the dude's like a Star Wars movie, keeps coming back." The comedian, who has never shied away from slamming Trump, tweeted this as he attacked the former reality show host and business tycoon who won the American elections in 2016, surprising many. Star Wars is an epic American space opera franchise created by George Lucas that began with the eponymous 1977 movie. The saga that is now a worldwide pop culture phenomenon will release his 9th movie in 2019. The saga that is now a worldwide pop culture phenomenon will release its 9th movie in 2019. 37-year-old actor had previously in a comedy show called Trump American's version of an arranged marriage. Veer will be next seen in a Netflix special titled Losing that releases on 11 December. He is also shooting for an American TV show titled Whiskey Cavalier. The shooting for his Go Goa Gone 2 starts early 2019. Indian actor Nawazuddin Siddiqui and filmmaker Nandita Das have been awarded at the 12th Asia Pacific Screen Awards. Nawazuddin was given the award for the best performance by an actor for his film Manto. The actor said he is honored. Honored to have received Best Performance by an Actor Award by ASPA 2018 for my favorite film Manto. This one is special, winning for the second time. Thank you Asia Pacific Screen Award and thank you Nandita Das for believing in me, APSA 2018. Das received the FIAPF Award for Achievement in Films in the Asia Pacific region. Das tweeted, "Honored to get the FIAPF APSA Award for the life and work choices I have made, feeling encouraged to continue to tell the stories that needed to be told." The filmmaker is known for her acting in the controversial film Fire and Earth and later in Between the Lines about gender inequality in middle-class India. Her first film as director, Firaq, appeared in 2008. Her second feature, Manto, premiered in uncertain regard in Cannes this year and has been picked up by festivals including Sydney, Toronto and Busan. Manto traces the life of writer Siddharth Hassan Manto. Nawazuddin Siddiqui has brought the character to life. It also stars actress Rasika Duggal. Krishna Shroff, the younger sister of Baghi 2 actor Tiger Shroff, says acting is not something that intrigues her. Krishna, daughter of actor Jackie Shroff and Aisha, interacted with the media at the launch of MMA Matrix Gym along with her brother Tiger and mother here on Thursday. Krishna has earlier worked as an assistant director in Tiger's Munna Michael. After Tiger's entry into Hindi films, there were reports that Krishna is also going to join films, and her Instagram pictures also tells the same story, but she says otherwise.
For me, when it comes to acting, I've always been very clear from the very beginning that that's not something that intrigues me. I'm not one to face the camera, contrary belief. I'm a very private person. I like my own zone. I like being in my own space. I have a couple of friends that I've known for almost 20 years now, and it's just me and them in my own little bubble.
Scans Accounting.
A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.